Did Figma just kill half your design tool stack? Because after Config 2025, it sure feels like it. A couple of hours ago at Config 2025, Figma just dropped 4 massive updates that push it into a full-on product creation mode. Websites, code, content, even illustration, all in one place. Now, as a designer, let me put on my Config hat, literally, and walk you through what just happened. How you can now publish full responsive sites straight from Figma. How AI can now build your app prototypes for you. How marketing teams can get their own playground. And how Figma is finally coming for your Illustrator subscription. Stick around till the end to see how these new tools could seriously change your design workflow or even your career path. Let's jump into the keynote. Okay, now we are in that keynote. I know, literally, we're not there, but it feels the vibe, right? So this video hasn't been published on Figma's official YouTube channel, which means there are some errors and some mistakes during the keynote. They might be part of later, but I really like that because it showed the live situation. But now let's drag to those points that we fear could be started to watch.
All of the details.
So yeah, we're all familiar with this guy, Dylan, the CEO of Figma, and he reframed, or like smart symbol, just mentioned those new features has been released recently on Figma. Also, quite like he mentioned that the key feature at Figma this stage is to keep the platform stable and able to solve this problem, like the lagging for large files. I really like that because he mentioned that there are 80% increase for people upload large files, and this is a before and after. So I think it's a perfect example to show before it's quite slow, and after the result is much faster. So a great way to demonstrate or to present your desired outcome. Right, let's go to the first part of what has been announced by this designer.
Now, raise your hand if you know where this is from.
Giorgio, the name of the designer. And he mentioned that the grid in Figma now is available. This is really cool. And I also like how he mentioned this from some historical background of grid. So we love grid as designer. We use grid everywhere, especially for print design, for early stage web design, and now as well. So we try to break grid, but still, they are still grid everywhere. I like that because now it's more like so easy to use in Figma. Basically, you can create a bento layout with a few single click, and it's also responsive. One thing that I feel really powerful is, or like a very valuable use case for me as a content creator / designer, is to create the thumbnail or the cover image for different channels. For example, on YouTube, I'm doing a landscape thumbnail, which is 69 like landscape mode. And on podcast, I need a square format. And by using this one, it's so easy. So I just put a background image and me as a foreground image, and also a copy, so that all the three different elements can be aligned accordingly to the final size of the layout. So I really like that, and also it's really useful for in product features as well. So yeah, keen to play with it a little bit.
Nice.
And the next big feature is Figma Sites. So as a short description, Figma Sites design and publish responsive website directly from Figma, complete with templates, breakpoints, and AI-powered animations. Also, a CMS is on the way later this year. So you can see that the end result is stunning. Let's have a look at the end result.
HTML and CSS. So while you're working, all of your designs are being translated to code that you can actually use and publish.
Please, there we go. Woo! We've got our fully responsive website with our hover effects, our parallax, our draggable fun badges, our classic typewriter effect. And down here, we've even used interactive components the way that you'd normally build them in Figma Design today.
I think it truly changed the way we design websites.
Figma's own Story Studio, who created the custom font. And
if you remember a while ago, like nearly a decade ago, we used Dreamweaver or Microsoft Front Page, where you could build a whole website with just one tool. And after that, design a website is a complicated progress. So basically, you need to ideate the concept and build a design interface. And you design the interface, the content, and then you code and implement the website. So there are definitely need at least two roles, a designer and a front-end engineer. And now it's different. It's like back to the old days. You can just build it with just one tool. So for many designers, Figma is the go-to starting point. Sure, ideation often starts with sketching, but Figma is the first real tool in the pipeline. So previously, we use other low-code or no-code tools such as Webflow or Framer for doing that, and maybe other like Squarespace. But now Figma enables designers to launch their website directly. This is a game changer. So I can already imagine some great use cases like building a small website for local bakery or butcher shop. They don't need dynamic content. And with a bit of AI support, you can build a site over a weekend. Wow. And Figma also seems to have done solid competitive research. Like they mentioned this, they highlight two major features, CMS and code layers. So for CMS, this is something that Framer has not done well. Now Figma got this feature going to launch later. And also the code layers, which enable the designer to create some complicated interactions on the website, like a calculator on the page, which is awesome. So yeah, there are many use cases we can explore. And also designers don't have any excuse to launch their own portfolios like myself. I need to update a portfolio soon. And we don't need Squarespace or WordPress or even Webflow for doing this. Just use Figma. So yeah, I think for me, I already subscribed to Framer for a year with plans to learn it deeply. But with this update here from Figma, I'm reconsidering. So time is the only resource which we'll need, right? So yeah, I'm looking forward to deep dive in these features to see how what is possible. All right, let's move on to the next one, Figma Make. All of those layers
in front of a live design, iterate, and explore. So let's get into it. Okay, and this is a live demo, and paste it into the Make prompt box. We're calling Earworm. Now let's say we just want to explore how this core player element will feel. Right? How the CD is going to spin, how those buttons will feel like to click. Now, historically, prototype design, understand what they're for, and iterate and incorporate that knowledge in its generation.
So in short, Figma Make is an AI-driven tool that turns text prompts into working prototypes and app code. So I see that it's powered by Claude 3.7. You can think of it as a lovable competitor or like a co-pilot for designers. So the demo here, they use a music player to demonstrate as an example. I noticed they're using Claude 3.7. So for this demo here, at the end, it's actually failed on the first try. So it's very typical for live vibe coding, right? I think this is something we can consider. Also, I think it's quite common. Like using other tools like Lovable, Cursor, it might happen again and again. So it's basically the same. But the benefit for designer is being able to go from concept to final to finish product right in Figma, visually ensuring everything look how you want. I think this is really, really nice. And also in the demo, it shows a point and update or a point and prompt feature. So this one is really good because when you click an element, you can update directly in Figma, or you can just prompt it, like change the interaction, and then update the prototype. So this solved the nightmare of engineers, or like designers tweaking one thing in code and breaking the whole page. And on other live vibe coding experiences, happens a lot. So I'm curious to explore this, but I might stay in cautious because it might not as smooth as it looks like. Even on the config demonstration, it fails at first. So yeah, let's see. All right, the next one, Figma Buzz. I really like the demonstration.
It gives you easy access to your
day-to-day work process.
Are you really working during the keynote right now?
Designers and engineers and products with some messages. And then they did this update in Figma Buzz. So for the context, Figma Buzz is a collaborative space for marketing and brand teams to create on-brand assets at scale, featuring AI-assisted image generation, bulk set creation, and brand-safe template. So on this demo, you can see that these two guys, they update these social media posts with just changing the assets information. And the final result is really impressive. Basically, they can update.
Oh my gosh!
They can update.
Look at these cuties. You know what?
The CSV files, so and then create those assets.
Send it to the student.
Just with one.
I did it yesterday. I really like that.
So. Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lauren.
I think it. For this one, it's quite like the direct competitor for Canva, letting you generate multiple assets for marketing purposes, which is really handy. And explain more job opportunities for designers, because designer might also do the execution part, or vice versa, also empower marketers to handle some design work themselves, because it's so easy to do now. So I think in this way, it could be a bridge between design and marketing. So while it's not the main most exciting feature compared to others, it's still, it's just for me, but still quite useful, especially for content creators. Once you got your one piece of content, you can quickly generate assets for Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, all the things with just one click. Speaking of which, the ability to create a LinkedIn slides or LinkedIn carousel with this tool could be a game changer. It seems like something you can put off just a few clicks. And yeah, you can do that. I might do some experiment later. All right, now to the last part.
One of the first things we worked on
editing
was trying to challenge the existing.
Okay, so I'll go ahead and toggle to Figma Draw. It's looking a lot more like a pasta shape. And pass. Okay, a few of you might have caught something in the Buzz demo that you might not have seen before in Figma, which was perhaps some text on the path. So now I'm going to select this text, cut it, because I don't trust myself to type on stage. Select this path, use the type tool, and if I click here, I can add text to the path.
You can hear the crowd is just crying, and literally this is the feature I'm looking forward for many years. Let's get it into two parts. So first, it seems so easy and simple. It's more about critical features. Before, you need to use Illustrator to do that. Those test alignment along path, and also those like in-depth vector editing mode. Also, I think now you can update the brush style on the vector images. And this is also another reason for using Illustrator before, but now not anymore. You can just do things all in Figma. Wow, such a game changer. Another thing that in general about this Figma Draw feature, before I use Procreate for drawing and Concepts app on iPad for digital sketching. Now that drawing can be done directly in Figma, I'm really excited. I used to draw a lot, so I still draw a lot, like 10 sketchbooks in recent years. And it's already frustrating switching tools. Draw in Procreate, then export to Figma for sharing or publishing, and little tweaks. So with everything now integrated into one place, much more efficient. However, I still need to test if it works on iPad. And I'm a little bit cautious about the potential lag, because drawing Figma is a cloud-based interaction, and that might not as smooth as a native apps. So yeah, still be able to change. Yeah, I think it's just good to have that function available. And you see on video, now they are changing the style and tone of the drawings. And yeah, before you need to use other tools for doing that, but now it's not necessary anymore. So the final result is using those four tools in addition to the Figma library. So yeah, I'm quite excited.
Please do say hello and have an
Now, this is the kind of comfy update that actually gets me excited, because if you remember last year, most of the updates were dev focused, great for engineers, but not that exciting for us designers. This year, totally different. It feels like Figma is coming back home, building tools that expand what designers can actually do. And I really like what Dylan, Figma CEO, said during the keynote. Design is no longer just part of the product process. It is the whole process that hit hot, especially now that these AI features aren't just shining demos or side experiments. They are baked into the design flow, right where we work with the same tools we already use. So yeah, I'm hyped, and I'll be using Figma Sites to finally craft my own portfolio, something I've been putting off forever. What about you? What would you build with this new Figma? Let me know in the comments. And if you're just starting out in design, check out this video right here. I'll share some thoughts and tips might help you get moving in 2025. Catch you in the next video. Ciao.